drinking bros. Put down the water and grab a fucking drink.
Just dudes.
We sound like cheerleaders.
Hashtag girls that do karate.
Cheerleaders.
Yeah, well, we always have to preface that with hashtag girls that do karate. Always.
Absolutely.
I'm just more concerned, you, Ross, over there in North Carolina. There's four dudes that are just tightly, and I have Jared next to me drinking a fucking vat of vodka.
He's not really drinking.
I can see it. He's spilling always all does over that. Himself like a child,
it's like a fucking baby.
It's
like a cinematic effect that he has to pour on.
You have to do it if you drink it out of the...
You're like an overgrown baby at Disneyland. An overgrown fucking baby at Disneyland. I've never seen anything like it.
Why is there so many dudes over there?
Is there a special guest tonight?
Yep.
Yeah, there is. Well, if Jared did an introduction, wasn't fucking drinking vodka.
I'm sorry, guys. I was having a quick sip. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's show, you have... big old, big ass, big belly, big chest, just big. Everything is big. It's like you packed a bunch of dough into a garbage bag. Big pop.
Whoa.
How fucked up did Jared get tonight before the podcast is my question.
Yeah.
That'll be a fun game for the viewers at home. Yeah. Now that we have video too, we can witness your disgusting fucking drinking habits.
Well, yeah. Jared went to the gym like three times now, so he feels it's cool to call Rocco fat.
Well, he finished 20 minutes after me today.
I didn't mean he was really fat. I was just kept calling him big because the last episode when I kept saying big, 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 the looks on his face were continually more awesome.
How big does it have to be?
Now that Ross is on FaceTime, Jared's just going to talk to the phone.
I've got to look at the camera.
He's like, oh, God, hi. Ross, I miss you.
Yeah, I got to remember to look through the camera, too. Because a lot of times I get lost in your eyes, Matt, and I can see you stealing glances. And one of these days, I'm not going to give them back.
Why is your microphone shaped like a penis?
It is from over here.
I had it molded, so I had my dick molded into a microphone. The whole thing, what you're seeing. So you're seeing the whole live version right now. You're seeing the full Ocho.
If it's your own dick, it's not gay.
I like that.
If it's your own dick, it's not gay.
It's a lot of confidence.
All right, before we go gay, can we get the rest of the crew going?
Yes, we can.
The best tattoos, the best biceps in the bunch, Mr. Matt Bess.
I got a nice one. Thanks, buddy.
That is a nice one.
Hello, drinking bros.
That is a nice one.
You're an asshole, JT. You fucking asshole.
Just a fuck ton of cookie dough in a fucking past plastic bag.
I'm doing the next introduction. I'm going to blast you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're going to do JT.
You have me, the guy that drinks out of a French press.
Yeah.
Mr. JT. We have the only big dick. On the podcast.
Yeah.
Mr. Ross.
The only one. And now that I got my microphone molded like my own cock, my dreams have come true. All of my dreams have come true.
Boom.
And our special guest for tonight, one of the OG YouTubers, one of the first guys to get that gold little play button.
Oh, jeez.
Mr. Richard Ryan, king of the slow-mo.
Welcome, Richard Ryan.
Welcome.
The king of YouTube is what they're calling you. Is that true?
I mean,
the king of YouTube is what they're calling you. What are the rules?
Can we talk about everything on here, or can we talk about nothing on here?
I mean, there's
a fact about you that would have greatly impressed Ross.
It has
to do with some dating history.
I don't know. I don't know. We
don't have to. Trust me.
I honestly, I have no idea. I'm pretty much an open book.
Pretty much.
Well.
Oh, no. Hell no.
I bet it involves a dude. Does it involve a dude?
It was a dude.
It was a dude. A very famous dude. Yeah. A lot of points on the board.
Hey, my life's an open book. Hell no.
We're off to a bang here, Richard Ryan. We're off to a fucking bang.
That is so funny.
That is.
I think everybody's the same.
First question. Nope, I won't answer that. I plead the fifth.
Yeah.
I ain't that get offended. No, fuck. No, fuck you. Fuck you.
Your honor.
Fuck you for bringing that up.
Well, it's funny.
I will answer any questions the prosecution might have, but I want to start off by saying I plead the fifth.
Wow. Wow, you're like Martin Shkreli.
You're like that.
You're like Martin Shkreli, that guy in front of fucking Congress about the AIDS drugs.
I wasn't gonna say his name. I was gonna say that cocksucker that owns.
Dude, either way, his last name is impossible to pronounce anyways. He'll be dead in 2 years. That's my prediction with that guy.
His face is really ugly to me.
Dude, what I was going to say is that we're all can be in the position of that where it's like, no, I'm an open book. And then your best friend says, how about that? You're like, never mind, I'm not an open book.
No.
Fort Knox is big.
Yeah.
Fort Knox.
Hey, do we have sponsors, Ross? I feel like I'm having to fucking, you know, carry everybody along.
We do, but, you know, since Jared was introducing everybody else, nobody introduced Jared. So our little fat bottom girl. Is Jared Taylor over there?
He said the French press drinking himself. He did bring it up.
I'm not fat bottom girl.
You were too busy talking to your own dick, bro.
Oh, whatever. So, sponsors tonight, we've got, of course, the finest whiskey in all of the lands, Lead Slinger's Whiskey. Let's hold up a bottle for the camera. Hold up a bottle for the camera.
You can actually see. It's weird. I'm going to hold it to you. I'm going to drink napalm, dude. This is
love it.
OG, and then we have napalm.
Love the napalm. We had some of that napalm in Vegas. Man.
Our new motto for that is stop the Canadian.
It is. Stop the stop the fucking Canadian.
Why is that?
Fireball is Canadian.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
That napalm, by the way, we might as well have named like it Lead Slinger's Cosby, because that took down both of our wives in one night, Matt, if you remember.
Oh, jeez.
That's funny. Oh,
bringing the heat. Oh,
it was good. Two of us and up chatting like women till 7 in the morning. Both of our women passed out after drinking that napalm. They were done.
Just the two of us.
This is Jared Taylor. Welcome to Jared Taylor.
God, you've got a hole in your lip.
We've actually been thinking about hiring a personal assistant just to help him with every fucking thing
he
does.
Like daily hygiene.
Just drinking.
You need a straw. You need a straw.
I don't need a straw. I got a French press.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Lord.
Sponsors.
Sponsors.
We got A Night She Cries While He Rides His Steed. Ever written of all time. The funniest book ever written. It's available on Amazon, Audible, you name it. It's fucking everywhere.
Last time you had it in front of the mic stand.
Yeah, put it up, Rocco. Don't be afraid to show it. Don't be afraid to show it.
You're like a shitty brown Vanna White.
Yeah, bro.
You are.
But
you are. Just shake that little sex novel. Shake that little sex novel.
I like that. Shake the sex novel, Ross. I like that.
Shake the sex novel, Rocco.
Part of the dick just popping.
I was shaking it. I shook it.
Pops when it comes out of your mouth.
Shut the fuck up, JT. God, tonight it's one of those nights.
It is. It's going to be a long one. We've all been drinking, and it's Thursday.
I feel like it's going to be a long one.
I'm glad I got in on the first episode.
Yeah.
JT is going to be fucking.
Yeah.
He's already trashed. It's because he worked out so much today.
There's a lot of vodka.
I didn't eat today. I had one of them power bars from Killcliff.
Oh, you without Jimmy John's is an appetite for destruction is what it is.
Hey, hit those sponsors, Ross, because then I want to tear Jared apart real
quick. Yeah, absolutely. The 212 Airborne unit.
No, it's the 212th Rescue Squadron.
You bet it is.
The Alaska PJs. They gave me this hat.
Did they really?
I'm really proud of the hat. Yeah.
Oh, they should have given you a better colored beret, you fucking tech.
Yeah. they gave him that because he
fucking... I got you, PJs.
They gave him the hat because they had to rescue him off the fucking mountain. Here's your souvenir, kids.
You better watch out. There's more tech peas than there are PJs. You're going to get a lot of black beret hate tomorrow.
That's all right.
Hey, as long as we don't get any brown snow, we're fine. It was not moss. It was not moss.
So gross.
It was moss. It was bad moss. I'm sticking to my story.
And last but not least, we have Richard Ryan's amazing YouTube channel.
Lead Farmer.
It's actually full.
Oh, yeah.
Lead Farmer and Full Mag.
And honestly, Ross, like, I love the designs of his shirts. Oh, like, look at this one. It's got E.T. and he's got a sniper rifle.
It's got an alien.
It's got a bicycle.
Alien on a bicycle with a sniper rifle.
It's like E.T.
Look at how nice that is.
Nothing like E.T.
I mean, look at it. This is not.
No, it actually looks like an older gentleman, maybe a librarian.
Well, and he obviously is wearing a raincoat.
Yes,
and
a poncho.
And he's on a Haro bike, and Haro bikes were not around in 1986.
That's correct. That's correct.
Well, to build some context for the audience and maybe Ross as well, Richard Ryan as we said earlier, is a YouTuber. He came along back in the day with Totally Sketch and all those guys, and I used to watch the shit out of your content, man.
Aww,
and not even stroking your dick, man. You're a great dude, and we've become good friends and business partners, but he, dude, killing it back in the day. And your Owen Wilson impression is the funniest fucking shit I've ever seen in my life.
Thank you.
But now, for all the gun lovers out there, Richard runs a YouTube channel called Full Mag, formerly known as Rated R, and he does some of the most badass phantom fucking high-speed camera slow-mo you've ever fucking seen. Blowing up shit, fucking C4, yes. C2 data sheet, debt cord,
and wait.
Fucking 50 cals, artillery, everything. It's awesome.
Sometimes I vlog, sometimes underwater basket weave, wingsuit.
Wingsuit, everything.
I'll tell you what, something that we need to make happen this year in 2016 is we need to get your Owen Wilson matched up with Ross's, Ross, what's your best
McConaughey. McConaughey and Owen Wilson
sick.
Together.
Oh, yeah.
Sick. That would be a good one. In a limo.
Oh, man, just partying in a fucking limo together.
Isn't
there some plans in the next couple of days we might be doing?
Yeah. By the way, let's start off there. I saw Matt Best riding around in a fucking limo today, which is something Matt Best doesn't do on a regular basis.
No, yo, fuck limos.
Yeah. And I want to know what the fuck, one, what you're doing in it, why you have free access to it in the middle of the day. You were riding around in gym shorts in a fucking limo.
Yeah, about that. It's not really free access. I bought the limo.
Yeah, Richard bought the limo.
Yeah.
You bought the limousine.
Richard bought the limousine.
Yeah, I'm doing a promotional video for London Has Fallen.
Okay.
Coming out.
And so they made you buy a limousine to drive yourself to the premiere?
No. So usually studios will come to me and they'll say, hey, look, we have this stuff that we want to promote. What could you do for us? And so like back in the day, for example, Relativity was like, hey, we bought this movie, Act of Valor. We want to see what you could offer us to do to promote it. So I gave them a menu of things from like a Halo jump, doing a video on drones to all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
And so for this, I gave them a menu of things and they're like, all right, well, that limo explosion sounds pretty fucking
tight. It's kind of the coolest conversation you get to have when your friend calls and goes, hey, man, I bought a limo. Can I drive down to your house and use your ranch and blow it up?
When are you guys scheduled to blow this fucker up?
We're going to do some filming Sunday and Monday and then doing some...
We're going to do stunts.
Yeah, we're not going to spoil it. I hope I don't die. I'm going to do something crazy.
Yeah.
We're going to do stunts.
We're going to do a lot of shit to it.
Tuesday, we're going
to
blow it up.
Stunts that none of us are rated to do.
But the limousine will explode, correct?
On Tuesday.
Okay, good, good.
Wednesday is when we're
blowing up the fucking limo to the world.
And we do all our own stunts. We do all our own stunts. And everything we've done.
Are you just
Rocco takes all his own shit.
You've done one movie, now you do your own stunts.
So I do my own stunts.
For a car commercial.
Used car commercial on local television.
Yeah.
It's
a damn fine commercial.
We were lauded by the station that said that was hands down the funniest commercial they've ever seen come through.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, my tailbone felt great and shit, you know.
I'm sure. How about the girl who worked at the car dealership? Who was the blonde girl?
That is the owner's daughter.
Okay, good, because I was going to say some things. All I'm saying is this. She looks like she's a very talented girl. She's very nice. She looks clean.
She has a lot of options.
For El Paso, that's probably the best option there.
I asked Rocco, and this is a true story. I don't give a fuck because I'm friends with her father. But I was like, when I walked into the car lot, I was like, yo, who's that? And luckily I didn't say it to him. Like, yo, who's a chick? I'd smash her. And like, that's my daughter. Like, oh, fuck. Guess we're fighting. But
he was cool. He was okay with it. He's probably used to.
No, I came to Rocco first. He's like, yeah, that's his daughter. Like,
No. Knowing him though, like he would be like, I'm cool with that, but you have to marry her, and I get to wear a crown at your wedding.
I don't know about that, but I feel like it would be like,
I'm down with that, and I get it. You know what I'm saying? And you get free used cars for the rest of your life,
dude. That would be awesome.
Matt, you could be driving a 1988 Tahoe. For the rest of your life.
And be like, take your pants off. That is, take your fucking pants off.
That is like dating a guy at the bowling alley. You get free bowling games.
Oh,
what the fuck?
Who wouldn't love that? Of course, Jared picks the one sport where you have to spray the shoes afterwards.
No, maybe, yeah. Maybe, yeah.
Like, man, Tom comes home and his hands smell like Lysol, but man, I love him.
Listen, she said she got fingered, but I know she got fucked.
What the fuck was that?
It just keeps going darker.
That sounds like JT's drank a lot.
Yeah, so on that note, Jared, what are you drinking? Drama. Not that it's not obvious, besides straight vodka and a French press. Yeah,
I'm drinking Tito's. Tito's and diet. Tonic water.
There
is no such thing as diet tonic water.
I'd say
tonic water without the bubbles in it.
Well, carbonation doesn't have calories. But yes, I did purchase that for a fat bottom boy.
Okay, what about you, Matt Bass? What are you drinking?
Watch my figure.
I have a multitude of things. I am drinking a Guinness Blonde American Lager. I've done this before. And then I have Napalm and Lead Slinger. So I'm just taking little sippy sips.
Look at you. How about you, Rocco? What do you got?
I showed up late. I was doing the family thing, so I got a cooler full of shit from the fridge. Coors here, Miller High Life earlier, and then I'm taking sips of some of the whiskey.
God, every night it's the fucking boringest thing. I don't even know why I ask you anymore. It's going to be one of four beers.
I'm sorry. Well, you know what? One of these days I'm going to show up and I'm going to have like fucking mushrooms or some shit. You know?
That's rad.
Like, what are you drinking? I'm not. Yeah. I fucking just ate the mushrooms, bitch. What are you Let's drinking? Go.
Yeah. Right. I've been doing rail since 9 a.m. Let's go.
But Richard Ryan is over here drinking vodka, no ice, just straight.
Look at that.
Is it warm?
That's
feel the glass. Is it warm? Because if it's warm, then it's even fucking...
Oh, it's warm, bro. It's warm.
That means he's cupping it for a while.
He's awkward.
He's so Russian.
He sets it in between his legs, Ross, so it warms it up to a cool 98.6 degrees, and that's really at the temperature.
It hits your bloodstream faster.
What are you doing?
Oh, boy, Jared, this is a recipe for disaster. Right there.
Dude, this is why we don't do FaceTime. We're FaceTiming for the first time ever with Ross. We're filming, and I don't really like it because my eyes keep going to you.
I'm doing the same thing. I'm watching Ross. I'm like, ha, ha, ha.
I miss his face. It's been like a solid 2 months.
No, seriously.
It's been a while. We'll be together in Los Angeles in a couple weeks. And by the way, I'm drinking Wilmington Brewing Company. They just started making cans. Yeah, look at that.
That is a great can.
That looks like Blue Moon almost.
It is like one of those. It's Jared's favorite. It's that Sneaky Goose from episode one, but they just started making cans.
Sneaky Goose!
And it's 9.3 IPA. So anybody out there, this is my favorite beer in the entire world.
The Sneaky Goose.
Ross, what hat is that?
What's that?
What hat is that?
This is Derek Jeter's from his last game. He gave it to me as he walked off the field, and he's
You're
just saying, hey,
shit.
If you ever do a podcast, wear this hat on your podcast.
Guys that, you know, were in movies and stuff in the early years. I mean, they get stuff like that from Derek Jeter, I heard.
Yeah.
I love Derek Jeter, bro.
I'm
going to get you some hats, though. They got some coming for us.
Dude, send me a shit ton. We wear the same size. Send them to my house.
Yep, exactly.
How do you know that?
What's the size?
How do you know that unless you've been in each other's bedrooms?
Yeah, douchebag. Is that the size?
Oh, no. It's it's actually the smartest guy.
Is there jealousy because we wear the same hat size?
It's MLB hats. Like, yeah, I walk around with a fucking MLB. I'm sorry.
God. Listen, I had a Dale Jarrett hat the other day and no one said anything.
Who the fuck is that?
You trying to like make fashion cool is like saying
Dale
like,
Jarrett is a fucking NASCAR driver.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm mean tonight. Why am I so mean tonight?
I think you forgot I'm Mexican. I don't know what that is.
You know?
I managed that when they go around the damn car.
He doesn't
track.
Watch NASCAR.
Oh, man. I would have paid for you guys to watch that.
I'm looking at you because you're from fucking Tennessee.
He's like, hey, motherfucker, validate it.
Dude, I had a guy in airborne school, country as fuck. And he's a good friend of mine, but he listened to NASCAR on the radio. And I'm born and raised in California. He's like, hey, man, hold on. I got to turn this on. Oh, shit, man. Number 43 is in the front. And I was like, you're just hearing noise.
How do the announcers actually do that? Because it's not like NASCAR has a lot of changes.
No,
so it's just like 43 still in the front. No, 43.
You got to get new tires and oil and all that shit. Like,
that's the thing. It's kind of like. You could say horse racing or whatever, where they like set up.
Boring
with
as fuck.
Horse racing is one lap.
I know,
and
I
you know who wins.
But it's like,
I've never been able to figure out who wins a fucking NASCAR race.
But you can. They'll talk about somebody setting up on a draft or something like that, and in going into a turn or something along those lines.
Richard, it sounds exciting as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right? Yeah.
That's
no,
what I was just saying, dude.
Looks exciting.
I love it. I'm glued into that. Did they call you Big Dick Ryan by any chance ever?
You know, I've had that. I had that in L.A., actually.
Well, you are big.
Wait, yeah. you are really big.
Who called you that? Was it a small Asian?
It was actually my my acting coach.
Oh, okay. So let's go down that road.
Is that the guy?
Was it a man? Was it a man?
Is that that guy?
You got taught by Emilio Estevez, didn't you?
Was it Emilio? Did you go to Emilio school?
I think it was, wasn't it?
No, I where did you get
did
that?
Did you go to Emilio school for acting?
You used to go to acting lessons from Emilio Estevez.
So your name came from Emilio Estevez, Big Dick, came from Emilio Estevez. Wow.
Yeah. Is that what you on his Mighty Ducks?
From the movie Men at Work?
No, Mighty Ducks.
No, Mighty Ducks too. Did he call you his little young gun? Was he your little young gun?
I wish. I tried getting him to, but sadly enough, there were actually multiple Richards in the class. So
you had a good acting coach, though.
Because,
who was it?
Jeffrey Marcus.
Who is that?
I don't know how to explain that.
Who is that?
He's a guy?
He's a guy that taught acting.
He's the guy that gave me the nickname Big Dick.
Yeah, because there were multiple Richards in the class.
Oh, you were the taller dick.
That's exactly
it. The big dick. I got you.
It's an ironic name because I have a micro penis.
Ross, you still have Big Dick. Don't
lie. On a scale from 1 to 8 inches, Richard, where are you lining up flaccid? Where are you lining up hard?
Oh, fully erect, like an inch and a half.
Oh, boy.
Well, yeah, but it's a hard inch and a half.
That's like an acorn in a pile of autumn leaves.
It can cut diamonds. It's an inch and a half that can cut diamonds.
No, I've seen it. It's 2 inches of flesh, but eight inches of blood. So eight ounces of blood. So it's real hard. It's not bouncing off the sides. It's shredding.
I actually measured the blood pressure in his boner when we were in Utah, and he had a 265/113.
Wow, that's great.
That's great.
You went to Rite Aid and you had him put it in the blood pressure. In front of everyone, right in
you
the pharmacy.
You should see the look on the chick's
face. There's a lot
of
hypertension going on.
She was about a cool 67 years old wearing a smock with a name tag. Just appalled at what Richard and I were doing with the fucking the blood pressure machine.
She had a shawl on, a shawl, like a nice shawl around her shoulders, like a mink shawl.
Yo, we should really say that's a thing, that blood pressure, like dick blood pressure is like a legit
That should be a measurement.
What's your DBT?
What's your DBT? Your ex had a 9-inch dick? I'm 6 inches with 240/112, bitch. My systolic is off the fucking chart.
My DBP is off the motherfucking charts right now.
Dude, if you have an 8-inch penis, but it's soft as fuck, that ain't shit, bro. No. But if you have a 5-inch hardy,
dude,
bro, it's like a fucking putting rocking. In a fucking
dude, fucking
like,
420 psi.
We're turning a leaf
no
on this.
Big.
You're gonna start. No yeah, big. You potentially could start cutting.
We're
flesh.
Leading a revolution.
Yeah, you could start a fucking revolution. That's what Bernie Sanders started with.
We could start.
That's what Bernie Sanders started with.
Everyone out there, start sending us your fucking blood pressure in your boner.
Right now.
Yeah, all you medics will get it done already fast.
I've always said, Ross, that you're a man when you can measure your dick in kilograms.
What is that?
You weigh it.
If you know it in Europe.
If it's above 1 kg, you're fucking legit.
Or stones. I weigh my dick in stones. It's three stones. It's 3 stones weight.
What's a kilogram? It's 2.26 pounds.
I don't fucking know.
Fuck, you're smart.
Yeah. Look at you, Matt. Look at you, Mr. MIT.
I blacked out.
I need one of them China calculators.
I need an abacus over here.
It's a China calculator. They built the railroads off of it.
I know what you're saying.
When you're deployed, you always have the 20K weights. You have to do the math to figure it out. It's 2.26.
I think you're right.
KG.
Yeah.
KG.
Yeah.
Dude, I weigh my dick in KG.
Yeah, KG.
Lincoln's box seat.
We should come out with a diagram with a new way of fucking actually seeing if your dick is.
Dude,
like,
you should do
the master dick.
You should whiteboard this.
Yeah,
and it could be just like that lawyer that whiteboarded the crazy hot matrix.
Yeah.
But it's the 2016 how to truly measure your dick.
Well, yeah,
it comes dick blood pressure,
impressive
kilograms.
Jared, I hate to stop you. Why a whiteboard? That's kind of racist. Like, can we do maybe like a tan board so that way it represents all the races.
Okay. I just think the white stands out better.
A lot of people say that, Blacko, and that's the problem.
White is better for literature, Ross. So it's better for literature.
People getting shot out in the streets over things like this. I just think that the board should be tan, maybe.
So you're saying black should be on white?
I'm saying a whiteboard is better for literature.
Oh, yeah, for reading. So for reading is what you're saying. So you should read in white. I got you. No, I just wanted to make sure. I just want to make sure we you know.
I don't even know how to talk. I'm like, I don't want to talk.
No, I'm staying away from this. Hey, can I get one of those Guinness?
So let's talk about Richard Ryan. Let's talk about your craziest limo story. I'm sure you've been inside of a lot of limos. There's got to be one that stands out over time.
Ooh, yeah.
I know one.
Here you go, buddy.
Oh, geez.
I'll whisper it to you.
No, really, don't. I'll tell you, the most recent one. Seeing how underwhelmed people are whenever I get out of the limo that I just bought, I was like, I stopped at a truck stop and everybody's fucking turning heads, right? Like trying to look and see, fuck, who's in there?
It's got to be Joe Namath.
I get out, I've got like a 50 cal shirt on, t-shirt, fucking sweatpants on, and a fucking trucker hat, and they're like, oh, are you off duty?
Are you off duty from your limos? Yeah. Your limo services.
I just haven't seen a limo driver dress like that before. It's like, yeah, I'm not a limo driver.
And then
yeah.
you say, I own it, bitch.
I bought that limo and I'm taking it to El Paso to blow it up.
Yeah, no,
Lincoln's box seats.
Lincoln's box seats.
That's our brand name. Lincoln's box seats.
Yeah. You goddamn right.
No, no, I don't. I don't have a celebrity in the back. I've got a flamethrower, a rig,
and I get all that. But have you ever been inside a limo and shit got really wild? Like you got really fucking crazy in the back of a limo?
Not really. I mean, honestly, the town cars are really what we normally like roll in. But the only time I ever go in limos, like,
Have you ever finger blasted somebody in the back of a town car? Then let's go there.
No,
come on,
what? That's a negative.
No, are you serious? Your stories are awful.
I know. I live the most boring.
But do you see how Ross said somebody because we're a general neutral show?
Exactly. Yeah. We don't identify.
Yeah.
It could have been myself.
Yeah.
It could have been myself. I just got bored in the back seat.
And you sat on your hand.
I identify as a female every time
I jerked off in an elevator.
What?
You had that much time.
Yeah.
You jerked off in an elevator? Where were you? At the Empire, like the Empire State Building, and you were the only one in it?
No, I was in Vegas.
What the hell?
There's a lot of cameras there. You jacked off in an elevator in Vegas? Like that footage exists then.
It was on Nellis Air Force Base. It was at the Air Force Inn there, so no one was there. And the doors.
If you worked at the Air Force Inn, please send us the CCTV video.
If you held the button, you could keep the doors shut. I peed in there too.
Oh,
afterwards?
Jeez.
How did you jack off and then pee in there? There's no way you had enough time for all that.
This was in 2004. You can't hold me accountable for that.
What?
It's like 12 years ago.
There's still camera footage of it. So, I mean, just a quick recap.
Yeah.
You jacked off and then you peed right afterwards.
No, those were two separate days.
Why didn't you just get out of the elevator
and go in a fucking toilet?
I don't remember.
Ross, let's talk about that. How hard is it? You have to pee before you jack off. You can't do both.
And then,
separate days.
Look, even if you're peeing afterwards, you're going in 9 different directions, you know?
Yeah.
Well, that's if you let it solidify, you go right after.
No, listen, if there's any guys out there, man, I've mastered this technique of morning wood because I used to be such a whore back in the day.
When you
have to pee, you take a knee and you directionally put it and you don't hit the porcelain, you hit the water so there's no splash. But that way your dick has a solid about 4 inches space between the water there. And there's no worrying about peeing all over your friend's toilet or your own toilet.
It's called the Rudy. But if it's called the one Rudy, night you stand, take a knee and you listen for your coach, you know?
Yeah. In best life.
It's my, the Rudy.
I do a whole different thing. I just jump in the shower and piss in the shower.
Yep, we're going to shower when it's like time to sneak out of there?
Fuck yeah.
Oh, you sneaking out of places.
Yeah, I've had to GPS my own coordinates to find a fucking map before Uber. I was like, I need to get my coordinates to call in the taxi, geez. Man.
We've had to save
printing off MapQuest directions before.
we've had to save a guy with a TomTom.
Yeah.
I do everything I can to not put myself in those situations.
We had to save a guy with a TomTom where he ran to a cross street.
And then he
gave us the cross street. We punched it into the TomTom and drove the van to pick him up.
Oh, Rocco, you're from SoCal, right?
Yeah,
you're
I am.
Fucking
I am.
Tom's Guides.
Oh yeah.
Oh Jesus, H4 to fucking find this grid here. Like fuck that shit. You guys have no clue what we're talking about.
No, hey, Richard, you might as well be calling out lotto winners from fucking 2008. I have no idea what that is.
Yeah.
H4 to like. I feel like we're in Battleship. Is Rihanna gonna come out?
Yeah, it's pretty much.
That's exactly what you're doing.
Like
picture a phone book. And it was L.A. gridded out, so if you wanted to figure out how to get
a Thomas guide. It's an old-school Thomas guide. Yeah. Matt knows what that is.
Yeah. That's it.
I know what a Ross guide is. Yeah. It guides me to love.
Yeah, it guides you straight to pussy. That's what a Ross guy
no,
is.
No, trust me. Your guy does not go straight. It curves all over the place.
Ew, God. Does your dick really curve?
No.
No, I just...
Straight as an arrow, stiff as a board. Straight as an arrow, stiff as a board.
I've seen that, though, on pornos.
Yeah, I've seen that, too, on pornos.
It's oh, weird. I almost... Yeah.
Well, hey, Matt, what about you? Any crazy limo stories out of you?
Huh? No, I'm not. I'm actually, again, you're going to hate on me for this, like always, but I'm not a limo fan, man. Not a limo
what,
fan.
What are you a fan? Like, what, let's get to, it's got to be Secretary's Day on like a Thursday that you're a big fan of. You hate holidays. You hate special things like limousines and balloon sets. You hate flowers. You hate candies. Sets.
I don't like Olive Garden breakfast.
Olive Garden breakfast.
Oh.
Hey, only if it's like in the soup.
Who has Olive Garden breakfast?
you got excited. You're like, I'll drink one more French press and I'm going to Olive Garden.
Yeah, I can see Jared ordering. Jesus. I can see you ordering breakfast over there and then doing the honor system on the Chianti bottles. Those shitty old Chianti bottles on the table with the wooden things.
Wooden.
And then just saying, oh, I've had two. I've had two. Yeah.
Actually, Matt and I went to Olive Garden a long fucking time ago.
Dude, it was
ago.
Like over two, a year and a half
2 years
ago. It was so fuck. You were getting your computer fixed or something in the shopping mall, and we ate at Olive Garden while we waited, and it was the worst experience we've ever fucking had.
We were at the bar, too.
You bite your tongue. Both of you bite your tongue. Olive Garden's a lovely and delicious place.
Yeah, I actually like
it. I love it. I love the bread. I love the atmosphere. They always treat me like I'm family there. The waitstaff always treats me like I'm
so
fucking family over there.
I swear to God, I hope you got paid $5,000 for that fucking plug, because Olive Garden is worse than limousines. I would shit in that place.
I would stuff an entire breadstick up your ass for that comment. Like, the breadsticks are amazing. The salad dressing.
Oh, I'm getting mad. Ross, I would pay a motherfucker $5,000 to not take me in a limousine to Olive Garden. That's how much I hate
both those fucking things.
You just
bought the fucking limo.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, I need an extra 50. Yeah.
I love Olive Gardens and I love limousines. How about you, Rocco? You got any prom stories in San Fernando Valley?
Can I sneak in there one more time
for it?
Okay.
Please.
Ross, the reason I don't like limousines, it's the same principle of why you think I hate holidays. They're amateur drunk holidays. Listen, if we've done on a party bus, and how shitty was that?
When you invite people, what I want to quote Matt on, and I'll let you expand on this because this is a perfect, I know exactly where you're going with this. Think of the day you and I arrived in Vegas for SHOT Show. We were in Hollywood's car and we pulled up at that stoplight with those guys in the stretch fucking, that's exactly what.
Dude, because, okay. Again, just like random holidays, it's expectation based, which I'm so hit. And he's talking about scenario. We pulled up these guys. It's these fucking wasted fraternity dudes.
They were all fat though.
Fucking limousine, bro.
Taking selfies at a stoplight, Ross.
I'm like
taking selfies.
Listen, if all of us are
holding bottles.
Yeah.
Holding bottles of champagne.
That's what you should do.
Drinking,
you know?
If the Drinking Bros podcast wanted to go in a limousine, I'm fucking down. But I'm not going to jump in some random limousine because it's a limousine. I'm going to be surrounded by A, motherfuckers I hate, B, shitty people that will get too drunk, throw up on my fucking nice Converses, and fuck them all. I'd rather sit at home, jack off my wife's face.
Is
you know?
Your experience like community limos? Did you take
the public access limo?
It sounds like you took a public access limo.
It's Uber XL.
It's like cruising in Sunset and people just jump in your car and shit, like old school.
Oh,
it's
dude,
like,
so when we got off the plane in Vegas, we pulled at the stoplight immediately. We're in Hollywood's truck. And there's just these dudes. It's like 17 white guys in a stretch fucking Escalade. Yep. They're holding bottles out the window like, oh, man.
That's Matt's dream. That's Matt's dream right there.
And it was at like 6 p.m. Like, fucking. You know that they
were going to the nearest. Who cares where they went? But they were like, hey, you know, had the guy park in the lot. Like,
but
you guys want to ride in my limo?
To clarify, I don't care. If they had a fun night, fucking good on them. Good. I'm just not going to be in that limousine.
Matt, I think they had the time of their young lives. It's what I think.
I'm sure they did.
They weren't young, though.
Just
like
that. Yeah, they were 30. They were,
and they were fat.
He just passed the bar exam with a C.
Okay,
and he's like,
so we have to change the limousine experience for
we
Matt.
Do.
So
yes. We do.
Yeah.
Instead of the frat boys like drinking.
Let's take the limousine out tomorrow.
We're going to take and we're going to armor out the limo. We're going to fucking put like guns all up in it.
Yeah.
There we go.
We'll put some
a flamethrower. Get a fucking flamethrower in there.
We have one. You know we have one.
In the fucking trunk. Oh. I kid you not. We're going to do a drive-by with a flamethrower.
Yeah. Drive-by, Ross. Oh, drive-by with a flamethrower.
Yeah. I love drive-bys with a flamethrower. You didn't see that in Straight Outta Compton.
40 mic.
You didn't see that in Straight Outta Compton, you know?
We made it. Yeah.
That's a happy face.
What about you, Rocco? I know you've been to prom once or twice or nine times with, you know, in the Mexican culture.
I've done the prom thing, but I tell you what, I haven't done anything crazy.
It's called a quinceañera.
I tell you, exactly. I was gonna say the one time I had anything kind of crazy and it wasn't something what you're expecting. I puked all over a fucking inside of a
amateur drunk scenario.
Yeah. No, I was 15 years old.
Amateur, you were an amateur drunk.
I didn't drink. No, I was nervous about because I was the chambelán, which is the main guy in a fucking quinceañera.
Oh god,
I got nervous.
Oh, there's a name for that. On you. There's a fucking name for that.
The chambelán, Ross.
Oh,
honestly, I don't even know. I don't even know if I said that right. But,
who the fuck doesn't know what a chambelán is?
I know.
Yeah,
I'm kidding.
It sounded like
I don't know if I said right.
It sounded like a mix between jambalaya and Chumbawamba.
Chumbawamba.
It's like Chewbacca ate jambalaya.
Dude, here's the deal, man. They make this. They made me. You're gonna be the main guy for the woman who's actually turning whoever 15, and so it's a lot of pressure on you. And so I don't know. I got nervous because I was gonna be the main dude.
Did you handle it though?
No, I fucking puked.
What
all
is after you threw up?
No,
yeah.
No. I fucking
what
puked.
Is the white person version of the quinceañera? Because
give me a sweet 16.
No.
Yeah.
Puberty. No,
it was like a sweet 16.
No. It was in the OC. Remember that was the first like episode of the OC. They went to the
Sweet 16, right?
No, it was the first episode of the OC.
Oh fuck! I don't know.
Yeah, let me rewind back to 2003 real quick. Was, buddy.
I love that.
What was that? What is that thing? It's for rich people. They have the.
I can't remember.
I don't even know what you're talking about. You might as well be talking about the facts of life. Like what happened in the first episode of the facts of life?
No,
a Sweet 16.
It was a party. For all the girls, all the rich girls.
Here, I'll Google it.
Yes.
What is it? A party for rich
white girls? I
can't
even hear this.
Yeah, in the OC.
It's Thursday.
This is
you
what
guys
Thursday.
Don't remember. You don't remember.
I don't, man, because you know so I've seen every episode of that, and I for some reason I can't remember.
That was remember they argued over who. That's where Seth takes Anna to it.
He's naming the characters.
Jared, honestly, as this keeps going on, this keeps getting worse for you.
You know the cool
this
thing
keeps
about
getting
that?
Worse
cheers
for you.
To that. Cheers to that real
cheers.
Quick.
Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers. There we go. First cheers of the night to Jared's knowledge of old school early 2000 TV shows.
No, it's a great show.
Dude,
but
it's a holiday, though. Well, like, it's a thing for rich people.
It is. I can't remember it. But you know what the coolest thing about it? Who was the girl, Rachel Bison? Bison?
Rachel Bilson.
Debutante?
Yeah, debutante.
Debutante?
No. A debutante ball?
No, that isn't it.
Dude, but every time she took her shirt off, it was the same song.
Oh, hey, are you talking about a bar mitzvah?
No, I brought that up. I was like, if you're confusing 16-year-old white girls with Hebrew,
No. He's looking it up. Whatever. Next subject.
Is it a bar mitzvah? Because there's a bat mitzvah as well. Is it a bat mitzvah?
No, it's something else, man. I can't remember.
No, when I say the word, you'll go, oh, fuck, that's right. That's the rich people fucking white girl dance.
Oh, Jared, I don't know. I don't even know where this is. Yeah. Now we're just staring at you on a phone right now. Like,
yeah.
This is terrible. You want to tell a story about your life?
Yeah, let's hear when you were four and you got touched.
I didn't get touched.
No, that was my story.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm not gay. I was raped.
Oh, shit, bro.
Cut that.
Oh, man.
This is why we don't do podcasts on Thursday nights. All fucks are thrown out the window right now.
That was the boundary.
And we're live.
Yeah. Give it up for a live
and
podcast.
And we're live.
Give it up for Lexus.
So, Jared, with your new workout and your weight loss, has the manager at Jimmy John's down the street contacted you? I'm sure their sales are down.
My wife was joking today because Domino's showed up and they thought they were bringing like a sampler, like, hey, I haven't ordered in a couple days. Here's a sample.
No shit. You're kidding. You're not serious.
No. No, they did not do that. She was just joking.
Oh, I was going to say, that's fucking weird.
Jared, I did get a Christmas card one year from the fucking Domino's guy. No lie. That's how fucking many times I ordered that one year.
That's crazy.
Dude, the weirdest thing right now, Ross, is like with JT's newfound I'm going to get fit kind of shit. Like,
yeah.
The other day.
It's a cotillion.
Yeah.
I don't. I can tell you, it's like a super Southern thing where they dress up like old Southern people and have a dance.
Yes, they wear the big hats.
That had nothing to do with the OC.
Nothing to do with the OC whatsoever. Honestly, all of that for that dumb answer right there. I cannot believe it. I literally cannot fucking believe it.
Now that he's working out, Ross.
I can't agree with you more, Ross.
I'm gonna say this. Now that he's working out, his brain works different.
Yeah, it does. But working out's got to help his dick blood pressure.
Though. Yeah. Well, yeah, hey, what's your DBP right now?
165 over 110.
Okay, so it's 110. Yeah.
Oh man. Oh, yeah. It's actually healthy. Real. No, it's actually 165 over 110. That's man. It's really high.
I'm 180, dude.
Oh wow. Really?
Well, because I drink so much liquor, it literally dilates my blood vessels to really optimize blood flow.
That's your baseline.
Hey, Matt.
My urethra.
Matt Best. Since we're gonna talk about our dicks all night, Legends of the Fall came on last night. True, I want an honest answer from you. Is it gay or awesome? Is that movie fucking gay or awesome?
You can ask them. I don't watch that shit.
Legends of the Fall with Brad Pitt, you've never
like,
seen.
I used to have a cowboy hat when I was like 13, and I'd get it wet, and I would tip it so the water would come off. And I would say that line to the girls that I liked, like, hey, what's up? I thought I was Brad Pitt.
Yeah, whenever I was younger, I used to fucking hate on Brad Pitt so fucking
much. Well, it's like Leonardo DiCaprio,
turned
the corner, man.
Loved him. Man. Oh, and now I like look back at like all of his movies, and I'm just like, fucking Fight Club, Snatch, California, all this shit. I'm like, oh my God, 12 Monkeys, all this stuff is just fucking awesome.
Yeah, he's a good actor.
He's awesome. So, hey, so Richard, Legends of the Fall, gay or awesome? You're like, what is it?
That's awesome.
Yeah, I know. I think it's awesome too. Yeah. Matt Bass, you've never seen Legends of the Fall?
There was no like dude sex in mountains like that other movie.
No, I've never seen Legends of the Fall.
Was pretty good.
Here's the thing, I might have watched it. I can't reckon that shit, man.
Indians, wolves.
You're kidding me.
Brad Pitt,
the fucking
cowboy.
His wife gets killed. He's in jail.
Yeah.
Like it's a whole thing.
Is Kurt Russell in there?
I'll watch it. I don't know.
Ross, to speak for me, dude, to be honest with you, I've never been a huge film buff. And I know we've had this discussion because you guys run rampant with like these reviews and you're so knowledgeable with all of it, but like how much I am in entertainment and how much I like the writing process, the creative process, I don't watch that movie.
You're a film hipster.
Well, no, we were all
film hipster.
I don't dis. God damn it, JT.
Hey, no, Ross, we were up like
I don't diss.
It's okay, JT found the hole.
Yeah, he found
again.
The hole.
There's about 8 ounces of vodka on your shirt right now.
No, there's not.
Ross, I want to tell you this, though. The best movie, and I had never seen it, and Hollywood told me to watch this, Crossroads.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
Britney Spears.
One of the best movies.
No,
the one with the guitar.
The guitar.
Your Soul.
It was the same kid in Karate Kid that played the blues.
Oh, yeah. But by the way, there's a Britney Spears movie called Crossroads as well.
Well, I've seen that too, and I love it.
That came out right around the time the Jawbreaker
came out. Which, by the way, would not surprise me if that was Matt's favorite movie. Of like, oh, hey, I've seen the Britney Spears movie.
I'm not Jared Taylor. I have good taste.
No. Britney Spears' is just called Crossroads. This is called The Crossroads.
Oh, sorry about that. Totally different now.
Sorry, Brittany.
No, well, Ross, last night we were actually filming late, so that's why we missed anything that was on TV. If that was on, I might have watched it.
Rocco and I filmed them until about 11 p.m. last night, and then I edited until about 4.
Legends of the Fall is a classic. It is a 20-year-old classic. It is Brad Pitt at his finest. Every woman. It was The Notebook before The Notebook.
Yeah,
it was.
For sure.
It was.
Sure.
It
really?
Was.
Yes.
It was America's
That's how big
love
it was.
Story. It was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you watched it with Melissa, she would literally, go down on you in 2 seconds. Like, you get it. I mean, they go to war. It starts in war. Like, the fucking brother
There's
gets
Indians.
Killed. Yeah.
You know when Indians
he
are
He cuts
involved,
out the brother's
like,
heart after
wolves.
He dies with a fucking knife. It's awesome.
Meg Ryan is all hot and stuff.
Meg Ryan's nowhere near that movie, Jared. Nowhere near it. Nowhere near that movie she's in.
Hey, Ross, real quick. About you got mail?
I don't know if you've been watching it all, but have
Hanks?
Keanu Reeves? Is
shut
that, is
the
he
fuck
you
up.
Got mail?
God damn it.
That's so good.
Ross, have you been watching it all, the OJ Simpson?
I love it.
Show?
I love every last goddamn second of it. I watched it last night. I had it DVR'd. I literally, when it went off, I screamed at the television because the juice was, he just got arrested. And he,
dude.
And he asked.
It was so good.
Oh, man. And the Kardashians, please don't kill yourself in Kimmy's bedroom.
Yeah.
Oh,
right.
I love all of it. I'm caught up in the whole pageantry and the magic of it.
Did they have Bronky Kong?
What's that?
What?
Was Bronky Kong in the show?
Oh, yeah. Dude, the Bronco was the whole episode last night.
Oh, yeah.
The white Bronco was the entire episode last night.
I didn't know.
Wait.
Yeah. I didn't know there's actually two Broncos, bro.
There's two Broncos.
Jared, wait, this is a great story.
I didn't know that.
His best friend, they were like, hey, how did OJ get his Bronco out of the car lot to drive away? And they go, he didn't.
What was his name?
Al Cowlings, AC. And so
AC, that's right, AC.
Yeah, and so he goes, they go, I don't understand how did OJ get his white Bronco out of the impound? And they go, he didn't. His best friend worships him and bought the same fucking car as him. Which is the greatest thing ever. I want a best friend who buys the exact same car I have.
Right.
So that way they can drive me around that for you.
We won't talk about your Bronco that guy.
We're all going to get
Mazda
Miata convertibles.
Fuck yeah. But you don't understand this, dude. Check this out. I grew up there. I don't know if you were out there yet, Richard.
I wasn't.
LA Riots? No, watching. We were watching.
I was in San Francisco.
We were watching.
I was in Santa Barbara. Yeah, watching it
live. So we were watching it live while I was going down, and people were trying to run to the freeway so they can be there. And so I always never knew that backstory where there are actually two different white Broncos, dude. Because we always thought,
I didn't either.
Oh my God, the white Bronco. Yeah, and so when I watched it, I was like, that's pretty sick. It was cool information, man. There's a lot of shit I'm finding out now that I didn't realize. And dude, I was probably in ninth grade at the time, so I probably didn't know all the information anyway, so I'm learning it all now.
Hey, but Rocco, after watching it, don't you wish your best friend had the exact same car as you in case shit went down?
Yo, I thought that was huge. Dude.
We had black Tundras together. Don't
we
even come
black
at me.
Tundras.
Yeah,
yo,
we
yeah,
had
black Tundras.
Yo,
yeah,
don't
okay.
come don't at or don't come at my
next
come
year,
at my
next,
best friend
Nate,
shit like
next
that.
Next year, we'll do it again. We'll do it again.
We'll do it again.
Yeah.
We'll get real weird.
Hey, did you finish Turbo Kid?
Here's the thing, Jared. I got about halfway into Turbo Kid.
I don't know.
It's a weird Netflix movie. I thought it seemed like a St. James movie to start off with, and then it wasn't. It turned out to be kind of a real movie, and I was kind of pissed off about it, Jared. I turned it off after a half hour.
No.
I do. I'm sorry.
It says... Have you gone through Narcos yet?
I ran through Narcos. Hey, Richard Ryan, do you watch Narcos?
I just started it.
I actually finished that, Ross. I loved it.
I like Narcos too. Awesome. My only complaint is I don't like the DEA agent. I just wanted the whole thing to be about Pablo.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Agreed.
Yeah.
It's weird. Way cool. The mustache guy, man, he throws me off a little bit. I don't really like his demeanor.
Same. Whatever. I'm the same.
Why we made that shirt. After I watched Narcos,
really?
I made the capitalism shirt.
Some guy actually messaged us and was like, hey, I love this shirt, man. I love this shirt. But who is it?
That's awesome. I didn't get it because I don't watch Narcos. Yeah, I was like, that looks like Pablo Escobar, but I don't get
Now you understand. And hey, by the way, that's Matt, I know you love Kanye West. His new album came out today. It's called The Life of Pablo. You're welcome.
I was actually looking for it. Is it really out today? Because I went on iTunes. I couldn't find it.
It is.
Why do you just bring up shit? You make me look like a negative person. I am the most positive person, yet you bring up limos.
He likes to bring up everything.
You bring up
that
fucking Valentine's
shitty.
Day. You bring up Kanye West. Like, again, I will fight him for charity. I will knock his broken, already fucking fixed
jaw. You could have fought him today, man.
Why are you so angry?
Yeah, I am the most positive person, but I'll fucking eat them.
What?
Listen, it's for charity. I'm trying to raise money for the kids.
For the kids.
Hey, by the way, kids. Ross, I did a lot of research on Stitches.
Stitches,
the rapper, the guy who got knocked out by the game.
Yeah. Well, the guy that next week we will have a graphic up on the Drinkin' Bros podcast. That is essentially Rocco and Stitches in the UFC.
Yes.
The verses with their reach, their weight, everything.
Yeah.
And we're going to call Stitches out on social media, but we're going to say, hey, bitch, you got two tattoos of AK-47s on your face. You send us a video of you disassembling an AK and then reassembling it like the correct way. And we might leave
not
you
in a million years. Not in a million years. Who knows how to assemble that weapon?
No, because I told Jared that he could YouTube that. I said, let's just go have a shoot off, and then I'll make you look like a
fucking
retard. Yeah,
but even then,
retard.
You would know if a guy YouTubed it. You would know. What I found out though is he has all these photos of him with a gun, and every photo is labeled as this is Stitches holding his AK, and it's an SKS. So it's not even an AK-47.
That's when he breaks down an SKS, and he's like, yo, I got it. You're like, this is my AK, bitch.
Yeah. That's not what's tattooed on your face. Oh,
man. Dude, that's a .22 caliber
pistol.
Dude,
it's not even close.
I have so much,
like, for some reason, I fucking creeped this dude because I'm just like, what the fuck's he going to say next, right? Yeah. And actually today, he posted a picture when he was supposedly 16 and some other guy was like, nah, bro, that's when you were like 18, because when you were 16, you didn't have that tattoo on your face, but you're just trying to front like you're a badass. The dude is like, yeah. Fuck, he keeps getting burned, bro. There's a lot of shit on that dude where he said like, hey, I got fuck this chain, and he throws a chain out the window, dude, supposedly so a fan can find it. And the fan finds it and then goes and gets it checked. It's a fake-ass fucking chain, dude. Yeah.
Same thing. No, I love it. I love it.
There's another thing where he says, I'm going to give $10,000 to the first person that replies. They reply, and he ends up fucking coming back and giving him $100. Not ten. So the guy's full of shit. He's just a fucking asshole. Well,
He's not a successful person.
So he's using social media to try and fucking...
I like the way you said that, Matt. It was very tenderly. He's just not a successful person. He's not a successful person.
I mean, he's not. You said I'm being mean tonight, so I'm just going to be very cordial.
Stitches.
Oh, I didn't say. No one said you were mean, Matt. You were fed up at the world.
How about this? If we can call out Stitches, I'll beat him in a rap battle.
Oh shit! I like that a lot.
To me, Ross, Stitches is a guy I would prank my buddy with by like sending his daughter home with the guy. Like, hey, just pretend this is your boyfriend, please. Well, because this is going to be amazing.
Stitches, the audience, because I don't know.
Because the audience, whenever they hear Stitches, they think of Jared bent over a bed. So that's with a split pelvis.
So Stitches is a.
On that note, I'm going to go piss, and you guys can talk.
Wait, dude, Matt, we're right. Towards the end here. You stay.
Okay. Yes, wait it out.
If you guys are listening, just go ahead and Google some Stitches. Stitches is a social media guy who just talks shit. He's a rapper. He's out of Florida.
AKs on his face.
Yeah, he has tattoos on his face.
Two AKs.
He has one AK on his face, but he has Stitches across his mouth.
No, he has AKs on both sides.
I don't think he does, actually.
I bet you right now.
Okay,
sorry. I just looked at you guys.
$80. $80, I'm calling it now. It's an $80 bet on the table right now.
I'll put $80 down that he has double AKs.
It's getting real.
Sounds good. It doesn't matter. The fact is, we're just trying to explain to the crowd. So that's who Stitches. Check him up on Instagram. You can see all the bullshit he's been starting, and so we're going to probably stir the pot.
Or don't. We don't care about it.
Either way, we don't.
But if he wants to be in a rap battle, I'll crush his soul, and he can say he's a gangster, but I'll literally.
Yeah, it's like, dude, you don't know what a gunfight is, bitch.
Well, not even that. I will outshoot him on a rifle course with my fucking Glock 19, and he can have whatever goddamn gun he wants.
He'll say he has an AK, but he'll have an SKS.
Yeah. Good for him.
Yeah. Hey, who's the drinking bro of the week? So Matt can use the bathroom because he's a little feisty.
Oh,
tonight.
Shit.
I'm itchy. Matt. No, first of all, we want to thank Richard. We're stoked you're in town, dude. Thank you for being here, buddy.
Thank you, Richard Ryan.
Your house.
You're definitely not the drinking bro of the week. I was just saying.
No, but you're a friend.
Let
me stay at your house. I was just kidding.
Man. Don't fuck that, guys. If you're listening to the podcast or watching it, please check out Full Mag and Richard and all the crazy shit he does. Again, Wingsuit Pilot blows up so much cool shit in slow-mo. You'll see us on there in the very soon future. So go ahead, Richard.
No, I was going to say, you're still on the channel, though. We did like several videos when we went to...
Yeah, we've done some shit together.
Really funny slow-mo of you guys. Yeah. Dual.
Super gay stuff.
You're doing tandem shooting. Tandem shooting.
We're doing tandem shooting. Supporting your hips as you shoot.
It was a support by fire position. Yeah. And the support was your hand in my ass.
How many views do you have on your channel, Richard, for the audience?
Oh God,
hundreds
of millions, I imagine.
It's at least like a few hundred million, I'd say.
Look at that! We got a real live person, just a fraction of the United States.
It's honestly an arbitrary number. It really doesn't mean anything. Like we tried tracking. I mean, this was like 4 or 5 years ago because you do collaborations with people and you put in the URL and you just track as the views grow what your affiliated views were. As soon as it got to a couple billion, I was like, all right, well.
A couple billion?
Yeah, it's like, well.
Oh, yeah.
Holy
shit. Are you
at
a billion views?
You're your own goddamn TV network.
No, but I am.
And then there's things that I don't want to talk about, but I'll talk about everything. So quit being bashful, Richard. What is it? You're a superstar. You got billions of views. What's next?
No. It's just I do so many different fucking things, right? Because the Full Mag is just a very specific the.
But that resonates with our audience.
But then
comedy
shit, half of the girls 14 to 28-year-old females like from Totally Sketch and everything. They didn't, when they see me shooting guns and stuff, like, what the fuck is this dude doing? He's wingsuiting? What is this?
Yeah.
And then the wingsuit guys will see me do like rom-com stuff, and they're like, what the fuck?
You're very diversified.
Yeah.
Jumping demos constantly.
The way I like tell people is like, you know, I'm like honestly just waiting for the carpet to be pulled out from underneath me, because I just get up and do whatever the fuck I want to have a good time.
And that's the way life should be.
That is. Right, and hey, and
American
on that note, who's the drinking bro of the week, Matt?
Oh, I got it, buddy. The drinking bro of the week is a good friend of ours. His name is John Hughes.
Yay!
Hey, John.
Yo, John.
Oh, hey, John.
No, but he lives in San Antonio, and he's just an amazing human, man. This guy has made a very successful life for himself, and with that, he has endlessly contributed to our community as far as veterans, LEOs, has done nothing but gone extremely and done extravagant things out of his... What he had to do to help out our community, and it's a fantastic, he's just an amazing
dude.
Dedicate
his time, like just
like his own money and time. God. He takes, he has a badass
control, the selflessness.
A deer lease ranch. He invites wounded veterans out all the time to shoot for free, to kill what would cost $5,000 to $10,000 to shoot. Just lets them come out and shoot. I mean, he let me shoot there as well, and
he flew out to L.A. just to drive us to Camp Pendleton.
Yeah, he did. And he flew out here, too, just to give a taser one time. And we've never asked him for these things. He just wants to be involved in the community. And he sees us trying to give back. And however he can facilitate that, he does. So
that's awesome. John. Hey, cheers. Cheers to John.
Special cheers.
Cheers to John.
Keep the good shit up, brother.
And, hey, Richard Ryan, thank you for being on the show tonight. That is it for Drinking Bros. You. For Matt Best, Jared Taylor, Rocco, and Mr. Ross Patterson. Good night, everyone.
Love you all.
Yeah.
Hey, let me piss in your mouth, Richard.